How is it possible to be two places at once? Well, with Microsoft Mesh, it is possible, and it's all 3D, which it turns out is the way my brain works, and I think your brain works too. I'm really excited to show you this next demo and hear from Simon all about the new Microsoft Mesh and how it works with HoloLens 2 to give you a collaborative 3D environment like you have never seen before. Take a glimpse into the future here on The Solution Show with Corey. Hi there. I'm so excited to be here with Simon Skaria and talk a little bit about Mesh. Simon, tell us a little bit about your role, and then we'll dig into some of the coolness of this awesome product.
Corey, thank you, first of all, having hosting me on the show. It's so wonderful to catch up with you after such a long time. I have the lucky job of being the leader of product for Microsoft Mesh. A couple of years back, we started thinking about, on the baseline of the highest watermark in mixed reality, this product that we have now come to call HoloLens 2. How do we think about a substrate that actually connects across AR to VR, 2D to 3D, from the devices that Microsoft makes to the devices that other companies in this space makes? And this product was kind of the impetus for this product was formed, and I was lucky enough to be tapped to sort of lead the product team for it. And here it goes 2 years later.
Tell us a little bit about, maybe start with sort of what problem are we sort of trying to solve, and then how does Mesh with HoloLens actually enable and solve this problem?
Yeah, I think fundamentally there are two things that that we think about when we say Microsoft Mesh, right? One is the whole question around the lack of engagement, the lack of connection that permeates across the 2D-based presence technologies, right? As inefficient as it is, as expensive as it is, it always makes me sort of wonder, why is it that we still have to get on a plane and travel halfway around the world and fight with the jet lag and all for usually like 2 to 3 hours of a business meeting? Or if it's somebody like me who is still a second generation immigrant here in the US, the question about if I need to go see my loved ones and if I need to go attend my parents' 50th wedding anniversary, we still have to travel all the way around here. And so the first problem or the opportunity that mixed reality in general and Microsoft Mesh specifically goes after is delivering that presence where you truly feel like, hey, how can we feel like you are genuinely there? As you and I talked about, it sort of brings sort of social context around where you are looking at, where I am pointing at. It just brings about a very different level of connection in mixed reality. The second problem is even more fundamental, Corey. It's kind of interesting, right? Like when we look at the 2D mediums that exist in the real world, whether that is paper, whether that is this computer screen, whether that is signboards on the side of a street, it's always interesting to look at how come most of the time when it's time to talk about the 3D world, we usually use mediums that are 2D, right? Hmm. And in the process of communicating about a 3D world, you kind of natively lose one of the dimensions to it. And you can see companies like, city planners who create a three-dimensional model of a city that they are designing, or most of the higher-end cars, when they are designed, usually have like somebody spend hundreds of thousands of euros, multiple man weeks building out a clay model so you can actually get the true tactile sense of a 3D. There's definitely cases where we use 3D to convey to them, but most times, conversations, communications, collaborations of a 3D world is done using a redacted medium of 2D. So the two big problems, if you will, that Microsoft Mesh is going after is how can we truly deliver a real life-like presence? That's why we use the tagline, here can be anywhere. And then in the context of communication and collaboration, how can we bring about that third dimensionality that we have lost since the last time cavemen draw on the side of the wall? and sort of bring about this new generation of communication. Those are the two problems and opportunities we go after.
And so you're saying that the progression from 2D to 3D is similar to cavemen to today. And so we are now entering post-caveman time. And I'm super excited because this demo, I get to take part in. So I'm gonna wire up here, and I think we're gonna go and play around with this right now. So let's take a look at what's possible with this new capability.
Let's most certainly do that.
I'll meet you in there, man.
All right, let's mesh together, man.
Let's mesh indeed.
The best way to experience Microsoft Mesh is through one of the emblematic apps that we have launched. It's conveniently called the Mesh app for HoloLens. And herein, once I invite you, we can have a great experience together and get a sense around the presence and collaboration that I talked about.
How's it going, Corey?
Oh, excellent. I have, as you can see, I've spent a lot of time fixing up my hair. So I've been really working on it. And so it's really took me a while to get it right. So that's why I'm a little bit late.
Excellent. Since you moved from the West Coast, it's the first time I'm actually, quote unquote, seeing you. Though it's not really in person, I just want to say there's a natural connection and an eye contact. Give me a high five.
Mm.
Excellent.
Nice guy.
Excellent, man. Excellent. Namaste.
Namaste to you.
Give me a thumbs up. There you go.
And then the side excellent. Thumbs up. I don't know if that actually works, but I'm going to do it anyway.
There
it
does. Side works too. Excellent. I love your hairstyle. Or, you know, you asked me what are the kind of things that we could do out here. If you are interested, I just wanted to give you a quick tour. If you could see this thing, Corey, like if you raise your hand, you obviously get to see the hand menu. Menu have a set of spaces that is foundational to the principle about Microsoft Mesh. And the spaces are just like, you know, I like to say like conference rooms, except conference rooms that you walk in and out, we think about spaces as something that is persisted across time and space. You can create these spaces, you can invite a number of participants to that space. And in this case, I've created a space called Lunch with Corey. It's lunch hour here. I assume that you probably are having a snack out there in the East Coast.
Right.
Excellent, man. So, you know, and then obviously the other principles are, you know, there is the notion of tools. So these are annotations. I always think about one of the things that I really miss out in in-person meetings is the ability to annotate, whether that is in a whiteboard or a paper or something. It also has integration with OneDrive as well as the local device file system, so that somebody truly want to bring a 3D model into the space and collaborate on it. Obviously, it brings a completely different dimensionality to the conversation.
What about the Moon app? Shall we?
Indeed.
Shall we start there?
Let's do that. You know, you brought the moon to me, both literally and figuratively. Let me bring the earth also into it. It says it's loading the model. I don't know whether you can see it now.
I can.
Excellent, man. If I bring up an annotation tool in here, your fingers readily become more like a pen that you can draw with. So I'm kind of going to draw a nice, beautiful line from here to there. You can see that my skills in 3D artistry is no better than that than in 2D, that I'm quite incapable of drawing a straight line. And then just being able to tell, you know, to your point about the classrooms, Corey, I loved it. I have a 14-year-old and an 11-year-old in their respective schools, and they're learning all of these kinds of things. Being able to say, 300 Corey, I don't know whether you can see it, you know.
I can, yeah, I'm ready with my exclamation part.
Excellent. And, you know, just to say, it's
make sure the camera can see it here. There we go, look at that.
300,000 miles.
Oh, 300,000. Oh, I'm sorry. I should have moved that.
No, no, you're all good. You're perfectly fine. You know, just thank you, man. You are quite a natural. You know, just being able to sort of visualize, you know, that is how much of a distance it is. And, you know, in terms of the applications beyond classrooms, there's been a number of applications. I know that you deeply think about the solutions for our enterprise.
I mean, it's so amazing just to see sort of the, again, to your point, sort of the natural way to engage in a 3D space, even though we're, you know, thousands of miles apart, not 300,000 miles apart. I think you could obviously imagine, like, both education, you can imagine, you know, being able to share content, being able to give presentations in a much more interactive way. I think there's just a whole lot of opportunity to really engage in a much deeper way than's ever been possible before.
Wow, I sure love that blue hair. And I feel like I could just reach it and maybe I can be cool again. But alas, I have to come
you
to the...
You are cool. You are cool. Cool again.
Oh, sometimes the virtual world could be better for that. But so, Simon, awesome. Can you tell me a little bit about, you know, some of the cases that customers are, you know, using this for more than just, you know, reshaping the Earth and the Moon?
Well, that's a great question, Corey. So, you know, most of mixed reality's early development started with remote assistance as a key scenario. So when you have an expert who is in your headquarters and you have a technician who's out in the field, the ability for the technician and the expert to work together has been super key. Training and learning something together is a place where Accenture is leapfrogging the world with the ability for them to bring in the new employees onto the company and being onboarded by their expert staff, being all together and learning together. Immersive meetups, you know, on March 2nd, we hosted the largest mixed reality community ever with our Ignite keynote launch on Microsoft Mesh. The other scenario we briefly touched on is design together, where, you know, if you are an automobile manufacturer or a city planner, you could actually bring your employees together from, you know, various different distributed offices and being able to have a 3D replica of whatever they are designing and have that tactile feel. And it's not unique to enterprise scenarios. If you are a consumer, the ability for you to connect and create for a tabletop game on a Friday night or being able to sort of join in for your family's sort of special events and occasions, Microsoft Mesh opens up those opportunities both in the enterprise as well as in the consumer space.
So awesome, Simon. It's really, really cool. So as a developer, what would you recommend as the next step here?
Yes. So if you are a developer, we would absolutely love you to join our early access program. So make a request at www.mesh.com and please sign up for the developer preview. And if you are an enterprise, I would highly encourage you to try out the Mesh app for HoloLens or AllSpace VR and see whether any of these scenarios resonate with your use cases at work.
It's so amazing, Simon. And thank you so much for joining me. Look, I mean, customers are looking for this meaningful connection and being able to connect with others. And as digital transformation accelerates this at this pace, ability to connect in a virtual way with mixed reality is so crucial to being able to keep up with the demands of that transformation. And what you just saw and what I got the chance to experience with the magic of the HoloLens, it was just stunning. The ability to see a 3D world and engage in a 3D world, like frankly, I've never seen before. This is going to change the way we all work and engage. And I'm looking forward to being a part of it. Thank you all for joining. And thank you, Simon, for getting us a glimpse into the future.